someone was saying yesterday that if people are optimistic, tend to live longer. It's a very healthy state of life to be in, and as long as it's not blindly so. It's a bit like happiness, isn't it? People always have lectures at university. What is happiness? What's going to be worried about it? Blindly happy. I mean, how can you be blindly happy about the world and all the problems? But you can be optimistic and content. I think it is a positive thing.
I would say again, yes, because it makes you think about how you could achieve something. You think, well, it's something I could do, so I will bother about it, rather than pessimistic, just won't try at all. So I think that really enables a lot of work and sort of the next step.
Absolutely. I mean, I think the view of the brain in the past has been quite pessimistic, because there was this view that we were born with the adult number of neurons and it was downhill all the way after that. Now we know that that's not the case, and because with a view like that, people would say, oh, well, if the brain is damaged or you're old or whatever, then decline is invariable. Now we can be optimistic, because we know we have a much more optimistic view of changes in the brain, and therefore we can use that optimism not to give up in the face of what we thought in the past was inevitable decline.
Yeah, I mean, I think the book is a very interesting concept. I would encourage people to read it. So many scientific discoveries have come out of optimistic thinking and now people thinking forward, and we need more discoveries.
I agree with all that, but my just personal view, it's being optimistic means that it's great to get up in the mornings, because there's good stuff that you can do that day. And since my very young kids dragged me out of bed, much to my disgust, it was about 6:15 in the morning, being cheerful,